Okay, welcome everyone again. It's Brian Peters from Customer Service Westfield, and appreciate you guys joining me. Today we want to look at installing or adjusting the thrust adjust nut, you know, at the top of our augers that sort of tension the flight and transfer weight from the lower bearing to the upper bearing. And there's a number of steps involved, and so that's what we want to show you today. So the first thing we're going to start with is we have to go to the bottom of the auger at the boot and install everything on the bottom so that we make sure we have room for everything. And obviously we have to lock up this locking collar on this bearing before we can tension anything. And that is what we just did. You just saw him with his punch locking up the locking collar. Now he is tightening the set screws. Once we have the locking collar tight and we have the set screws tight, then we do want to adjust the sprockets so they align properly. And I usually recommend that you use a measuring tape, measure from the face of the boot wall so that your sprockets are going to be the same. Once your sprockets are lined up, here we have a key. He has chamfered the key a little bit, as you saw, just so that there's no burrs on it, that you can slide it in nicely. Otherwise, if you have to beat on it, you're going to mushroom it, it won't fit properly, and you can run into problems that way. So chamfer the key and slide it into place. Install the chain. And you want to do all this before you go to the top, because right now we have the bearing, the pillow block bearing is still loose, so that we can lift the flight, which is what we're doing with a pry bar. We're just lifting the flight so that we can connect the chain. And once the chain is connected, just let the weight of the flight come down and make your tension on the chain. Then, once this is in place, we can go back. Now we can go to the top. We've got the lower bearing locked. The shaft is locked in place. Now we're going to go to the top and put a little bit of tension on this, what I sometimes call the noodle. I mean, there's multiple joints in the flight, and so we want to put a little bit of tension on it. We also want to transfer some weight from the bottom bearing to the top bearing. So what we've done here, he's tightened this lock adjust nut, and now he's going to back it off. So just so that what we do here is we've tightened it and we've backed it off so that it's just loose. So your nut is just up to, now we're going to give it two revolutions, and that should normally be enough. If you had a longer auger, this is a 74 that we're working on. You could go 2.5 if it's an 84, maybe 3 if it's a 94, a little bit longer, a few more joints. But 2 revolutions generally is good. So we've tightened it up now to where we want it. 2 revolutions. The collar on this bearing was loose, as it should be, for the shaft to slide through the bearing. And now we're going to tighten the locking collar on this bearing. Tightening locking collars, I always tell guys, I like to have it tightened clockwise, because that way, if you're always doing it clockwise, you know, if you're going to take it off, you're going to go the other way, the other direction. So it's just kind of normal, natural to tighten it the same way you would a nut or a bolt. Tighten the locking collar, lock up the set screw. Now what he's going to do is he's going to just tighten it a little bit to make sure that everything is tight up to the locking collar of the bearing. You saw him tighten it so that your nut is tight. We use a nylock nut so it shouldn't come off, but still I want you to tighten that nut one more time a little bit. Put the cap on, and you're done. You've got tension on your flight. You've got your locking collars in place. You've got the weight transfer to the top, some of it, and you're done.